The Book of Wisdom, very early on, in just the second chapter, presents an image of the person of God. Now, when we think of the person of God, we often think of someone who is holy, who is appealing, who is very prayerful, who is perhaps very affirmative, always tells us how much God loves us, how much God accepts us and forgives us. But here the Book of Wisdom paints a very different image, which we hear on this Friday of the fourth week of Lent. And it reads, "The wicked say among themselves, thinking not aright, let us beset the just one, because he is obnoxious to us. He sets himself against our doings, reproaches us for transgressions of the law, and charges us with violations of our training. He professes to have knowledge of God and styles himself a child of the Lord. To us he is the censure of our thoughts. Merely to see him is a hardship for us, because his life is not like that of others, and different are his ways." How often do we picture the just man of God as someone who is obnoxious? Perhaps this reading might read something different these days. Let us beset ourselves upon the just man because he's obnoxious. He sets himself against our ways. He's not politically correct. He is not affirming. He's condescending. He tells us all the things we do wrong. Let us criticize the just man because we don't like him. And that's often a challenging image for the just man. Of course, we, seeking that example of wisdom, hope to be seen as just in the eyes of God. But if we are just in the eyes of God, how might we look to everyone else? The faith of God, the faith in Jesus Christ, is not something that would necessarily conform to modern socio-political, cultural, and moral mindsets. And in fact, many people turn to religion not because they want guidance, but because they want approval. And if they don't get approval from the religious institutions for their own lifestyle choices, then they find it obnoxious. And therefore, in their mind, is not the ways of God, because the ways of God are not obnoxious to us. They're completely accepting to us. And yet the Book of Wisdom presents something very, very different that we can see in the example of Jesus. We can see in the example of the apostles. Many people found Jesus obnoxious. Many people found the apostles obnoxious. And the reasons were because they did not conform to other people's ways, but rather they conformed to the ways of Christ. Let us look and see how we can do the same. That we don't live our lives in order to be pleasing to the local, modern, current zeitgeist of the time. That we don't set ourselves according to modern social standards, but rather the standards of God. And then we might run the risk of being considered obnoxious. But in the eyes of God, we are his faithful children, because we conform ourselves not to the standards of those who would call us obnoxious, but to the standards given to us by God, so that we can live as people he created, to be the people he created us to be.